Good morning, everybody. Today is September 17, 7:19 a.m. Eastern Time. Good morning. God bless all of you guys, all of us. We need to pray every single day because, you know, we really need to have faith, and only one person, you know, can help us out. That is God. So we need to be grateful for the house that, you know, God provided to us, for the food that He puts in our table, the family that He provided to us, the health, the smart, the intelligence, everything that, you know, He provided to us. Use your time correctly. Use your time for you, for your family, for your kids, because life is too short. And the most valuable thing that we have in our life is our time. But the majority doesn't know how to use the time that God also provided to us. If your son, if your daughter, call you help or call you to play, go for it. Go for it. Enjoy your family. Enjoy your time and use your time in the best way. That's my message for today. Love all of you. Let's start this morning call video with a quick disclaimer as usual. I only express my studies, I'm not a financial advisor. Future stocks, cryptocurrency and options trading involve substantial risk of loss and is not suitable for every investor. The valuation of future stocks, cryptocurrency and options may fluctuate, and as a result, investors may lose more than their original investments, especially if you are leveraged. Let's start with the economic calendar that you have today. We have also a busy agenda, but you know, business start tomorrow and Tuesday with Bank of Japan and Federal Reserve. Okay, today we have core retail sales, retail control, headbook, ECB, Elderson speaking, capacity utilization rate, industrial production, manufacturing production, business inventories, Fed Logan speaks, NAHB housing market index, retail inventory, Atlanta Fed GDP now, and 20 years bonds action. As you guys can see, we have a bonds action and the yields keep falling apart, right? We are not seeing any discount window. So economy have been degraded fast and furious. As I explained to you guys yesterday, you know the case about my wife, you know the case that somebody that put in the news about the 2,000 positions that, you know, such person applied for and didn't get any offer. So unfortunately, you know, politicians have been messed up. The systems want to make us slaves. This is really clear to every single person. The systems have been created, you know, a political ideology. So nowadays society wanna fight per their political ideology instead of to group themselves, union themselves, and fight against the system. If you have a society that is already split by different ideologies, you know, the system just get more power and more control, okay? But anyway, the important are the level, the important the market, that's the way that you try to make some coins, right? To protect our heritage and try to keep your wealth. So as I put in the page 3, volatility skills still showing discrepancy between out of the money contracts. Anyway, vol skill suggests a gap up today. Of course, I provide the market starting the day before the futures open, right? So today, since support is around 3,630, 3,635. So far, future is giving us 14 points. If you go back and read the Friday, a market structure document that supposed to be support the entire the Monday, yesterday, and basically I provided the overview for the entire week. Today we expect the market trade between 5,630, 5,650. So where the major support will be 5,620, right? But for vol skew, the region between 5,630 and 3,510 to be the first level support, breaking down maximum downside target 5,620, not 5,605 anymore. That was the worst case scenario for yesterday. So I expected rejected 45, but you know they already brought us above 45. So we are back test 5,650, exactly what I told you guys several times in the market structure documents, in the open group, as soon as you guys raise questions to me. Pa, pa, pa. Let me see in the tomorrow, possible to trade between 5,630, 5,650. I posted this yesterday noon, right? Because it was the pre-setup. You just go back and review the week overview that I provide in the market structure document post to you guys on Friday, right? So markets do exactly what they pre-setup. So we have some discrepancies in the book, you know, in the options grid, in the vol skew, that suggests us that a pullback could be imminent, but the flow is still supportive for the upside. So we need to follow the flow. We need to respect all the levels, right? And especially we cannot have bias. If you have a bias and your bias going against the flow, you will lose money. Something that I don't advise to you guys right now, because dark times is arise sooner than later. We will need every penny that we are already conquers during our entire life. Okay, so for today, you know, it's almost still the same levels, still the same levels. The tendency to see market trade between 5,635 up to 5,650. I don't expect a break at 5,650 today. But remember that I told you guys several times to see a break at 5,650, a gap up is needed. So if you market, you know, keep it trading around 5,650 and close a little bit above, the tendency is to backtest higher levels. I post several times, especially in the market structure document, you know, the OPEX flow zigzag, right? I just wanna, and I also yesterday fixed, you know, these levels. So these levels start at 5,675 and could you go up to 5,720, right? But we will see a lot of resistance starting 75, going up to 5,680. So far the market's doing the movements as the OPEX suggests to us. Before, remember, I look for 5,505, but with a possibility to hold at 5,525, and then the pullback was up to 35, and then market, you know, get back to the uptrend, to the final destination. The final destination is supposed to be a very tight range that I show you guys. You start at 75 and could you go up to 5,720, right? Because this is the flow. But major resistance is starting 75 and going up to 80, okay? Because we have puts in dominance in the money. Could you be a squeeze setup? Of course, could you be a squeeze? Because that I have been telling you guys. If you break the region that start in 75, go up to 8, the tendency is to go up to 5,720. Okay? Fabio, this could be changed? Yes, this could be changed. Flow is like market, is dynamic. And because of that, we need to review it every single day to see what dealers are proposing to us. Okay? So, pay attention over here for the current DEX, Delta exposure. Look that we have weakness below 5,665. So we could see a pump and dump. I don't disregard that. So volatility today tended to be controlled. So the pump and dump tended to not occur. Right? Because look at the Vega. Vega shows that you see a supportive flow at the open. We are near the OPEC. So we tend to have a very strong VANA and CHAR. So VANA tends to be bullish. Future so far is showing that we will open with a gap up. Exactly what I post in the page 3 in the market structure document. Because volatility skill showing us a support between 30 and 35, suggesting is a gap up. Okay? So far, nothing changed. But let's check the GX. So the GX show us if you break down 5,650, we could see a sell pressure. Okay, because puts start to be in dominance. The DEX, you know, is negative, especially below 5,650. But the discrepancy that we have between DEX and Vega is because Vega show volatility suppression. So they could be, you know, setting up those regions to generate a gamma squeeze during the intraday to break 5,650 and keep market above 5,650. I don't disregard. Pay attention in the gamma, you know, the gamma exposure, the GX, the magneto intraday is 5,675. So if you really, really break 50, 60, the tendency is going and backtest the gamma at 75. Pay attention that the DX is located at 65. Since we are in a positive gamma territory, the tendency is to sell tops by bottoms, right? 5,665 tend to be the maximum upside target. But remember, the magneto is keep pushing us south. Sorry, north, not south. So keep pushing us higher. So the magneto for today intraday is 5,675. Okay? Pay attention in the gamma design that intraday we start to see weakness per gamma below 5,635. Look how funny it is. Check, not funny it is, but you know how structure works. Pay attention in the gamma before. We didn't see such, you know, weakness, right? We saw only weakness below 5,615 yesterday. Now intraday is really different, but it matches with what? The volatility skill. Volatility skill show us support between 30 and 35. So pay attention that the last, you know, not the last level of the positive gamma, but after this huge positive gamma, you know, the last level will be 35 before, you know, the flip at 30. So 35 and 30 tend to be the support, exactly what the volatility skill told us yesterday. Below 35, 30, we have 25. Right? Because, and also, what is 25? 25 is yesterday, is where we start to show weakness, 20, 25. See how, you know, the structure works. So, because that, I always tell you guys, that's really important to follow the levels, right? It's really important to follow the levels. So, the tendency is to keep the uptrend. We have the DEX, Delta Exposure, at 5,665, so tend to be the rejection, okay? The magneto is still keep pushing us up at 5,675, and we start to see weakness per gamma exposure below 5,325. So between 5,630, 5,635 tend to be the support. Breaking down, 25. And then we start to enter in a weakness region where, you know, sellers will be in dominance. Okay? So those are the levels. Eyes open in the region that starts at 5,625 and go up to 5,635. So these 10 points range are the inflection region to the downside. If you break those regions, we could backtest 5,605. But the tendency is to see market keep trading high between 30 and now 65. Prior 30 and 50. But we could visit 5,665. Okay? Volatility tends to be suppressed, so consequently, you know, generate doubt to me if you see a pump and dump. But of course, this is changed during the intraday. This is a pre-market, right? So we have divergence between the Vega in pre-market and the Vega in post-market yesterday. The Vega in the post-market yesterday show volatility at the open. In the pre-market, it's not showing volatility at the open, right? So we have divergence between yesterday post market and today pre market. So far, the pre market is telling us that you see a supportive flow at the open through VANA. Okay, seeing a supportive flow at the open through VANA, the tendency is to back test 5,665, and I expect a rejection. Okay, so inflection point for the downside is the region that started at 5,625. And go up to 5,635. If you break that region, expect 5,605 printing again today. Okay? Guys, enjoy your day, enjoy your family, enjoy the market, but use the market in your favor. No bias. Follow the flow, follow the levels. Respect the market. Market was built to be respected. Sometimes what we think is not the correct thing. Right? Enjoy your day. Take care. Talk to you guys soon.